சப்ஸ்கிரைப் மை சேனல். பி சரளா. Hit the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a new lesson.
Welcome to another class of neural system. We all know that neural system is divided into two parts, central neural system and the peripheral neural system. Central neural system consists of brain and the spinal cord. Peripheral neural system consists of the cranial nerves and the spinal nerves. This peripheral system is again divided into two parts, somatic neural system and autonomic neural system. Somatic neural system is under conscious control. So it contains both sensory and motor neurons. Sensory somatic neurons conduct sensory impulses from different somatic receptors to the central nervous system. Somatic motor neurons conduct the impulses from the central nervous system to the effective organ, especially the skeletal muscles. So the function of this somatic neural system is excitation. So it receives the impulses consciously. So it is a voluntary in function. So as the name itself, autonomic neural system, auto means self. So this neural system is self controlled, yet it is under the control of central neural system through spinal nerves of the peripheral neural system. So autonomic neural system is divided into two types, sympathetic neural system and parasympathetic neural system. So let us learn about the sympathetic neural system. Sympathetic neural system, so this is the sympathetic neural system. So it is present in the form of a ganglia or sympathetic trunk on either side of the spinal cord. So this is the spinal cord, on either side of the spinal cord sympathetic trunk is formed with the ganglion. So these are the ganglia. These are the cervical ganglia, thoracic ganglia, lumbar ganglia and the sacral ganglia. The caucasial ganglia are fused. So sympathetic neural system is present as a paired structure on either side of the vertebral column. That's why these ganglia are also known as paravertebral ganglia. So this sympathetic neural system works subconsciously or involuntarily. It is not under the conscious control. It acts subconsciously or involuntarily. So it comes to the rescue during the fight or flight situations. So these are the situation where the person has to fight with the situation, or he has to run away from the situation. During that condition, sympathetic neural system acts. It is a energy consuming or energy expenditure process. This sympathetic neural system consists of four parts: preganglionic neurons. So these are the preganglionic neurons which arise from the spinal cord, from the cervical region to the sacral region, and these are the sympathetic chain ganglia. So ganglia, here the cell bodies of the neuron are located. If the cell body of a neuron is located outside the brain and the spinal cord, is known as a ganglion. So that's why these are known as a sympathetic chain ganglia or paravertebral ganglia. So they are 20 to 23 pairs of paravertebral ganglia, because they are present on either side of the vertebral column or spinal cord. So some say that these are 22 in number, some 23. So here the third cervical ganglia and the first thoracic ganglia fused together. That's why some say these are 22 in number, but some say these are 23 in number. If we consider third cervical and T1 ganglia as a separate one, so then it comes 23, otherwise 23. So preganglionic neurons are 22, the cervical attribute 3, thoracic 12, lumbar 4 and the sacral. But the name thoracolumbar comes because the major portion of the ganglion are from the thoracic region. That's why This sympathetic neural system is also known as thoracolumbar division. Sympathetic neural system consists of four parts: preganglionic neurons, sympathetic chain ganglia or paravertebral ganglia, and the collateral ganglia, which are present close to the visceral organs. So there are three collateral ganglions are present in the sympathetic neural system, and the postganglionic neurons. So these are the neurons which comes out from the ganglia. So after forming the synapse with the preganglionic neurons, the axon which is coming out is known as postganglionic neurons. So here the preganglionic neurons are shorter in size when compared to the postganglionic neurons. So this is the postganglionic neuron. These are the preganglionic neurons which comes out from the spinal cord. So you have to remember that the preganglionic neurons are short in size when compared to the postganglionic neurons, which are long. So as these postganglionic neurons, the red ones, postganglionic neurons are longer in size, so the effect will be widespread. The effect of the sympathetic neural system is widespread. Okay, so we will learn about one after the other. So these are the preganglionic neurons which arises from the spinal cord. These preganglionic neurons take three types of paths to reach the target organs. You have to remember one thing, that sympathetic nerves do not go directly from the spinal cord to the target organ, but they pass through the cluster of neurons in three different ways. Okay, so this is the preganglionic neuron. So the neuron which is present before the ganglia, so this is the ganglia, it is present before the ganglia, that's why it is known as preganglionic neuron. So it comes from the spinal cord and enters to the sympathetic ganglia through white ramus communicans. So we all know that spinal nerve, after emerging from the vertebral column, divided into three branches: the dorsal root, the dorsal ramus, the ventral ramus, and the ramus communicans. Ramus communicans is divided into two parts: white ramus communicans and grey ramus communicans. So this is the white ramus communicans and this is the grey ramus communicans. Always the preganglionic neurons passes through the white ramus communicans and enters the sympathetic ganglia. So here synapse will be formed with the postganglionic neuron. So this is the postganglionic neuron. So this neuron is supplied to the target organ. So this is one pathway. Another pathway is the central or preganglionic neuron passes through the white ramus communicans, but it doesn't form synapse in the chain ganglia at the same level, but it moves towards upper region or towards the lower region. So if it moves towards the upper region, it becomes a superior ganglia. So the ganglia which is present above the level is known as superior ganglia, and the ganglia which is present below the level of emerging neuron is known as inferior ganglia, the upper ganglia or the lower ganglia. So if the preganglionic neuron doesn't form synapse at the in the ganglion at the same level, but it passes towards the upper or the lower ganglia, this is another route. So the third route is, so the preganglionic neuron passes through the white ramus communicans and passes through the ganglion, but it doesn't form any synapse in this ganglion, sympathetic chain ganglia, but it goes along with the splanchnic nerve. So this is the splanchnic nerve, passes along the splanchnic nerve and forms a synapse in another ganglia which are close to the organs. So those ganglia which are close to the organs are known as collateral ganglia. So if synapse is formed here in the collateral ganglia, the postganglionic neuron is short. So you have to remember this one also. So like these three pathways, so here, so this is the preganglionic. So here synapse is formed directly. Here synapse is formed in the sympathetic chain ganglion. So these are the postganglionic neurons. So these are the preganglionic neurons and they form synapse. So here from this, so they passes. These are passing through the ganglion and form a synapse in the collateral ganglion. So here they directly comes from the spinal cord, comes from the spinal cord and unite here and form a synapses in this ganglia. So these ganglia are known as collateral ganglia. There are three collateral ganglia. So the first one is celiac collateral ganglion, superior mesenteric ganglia, and this is the inferior mesenteric ganglia. And from this collateral ganglia, post ganglionic neurons are supplied to the target organs. So they all these are the target organs of the sympathetic nervous system. Okay. So one exception is there. So one preganglionic neuron which comes out from the spinal cord and passes through the celiac ganglia. So here it forms a branch and goes directly to the target organ, that is the adrenal medulla region. So this is the adrenal gland medulla region is supplied directly from the spinal cord. So you observe here synapse is not formed. It is comes directly from the preganglionic neuron. So this is the only exception. The sympathetic nerve which is supplied to the adrenal medulla is the only exception nerve which doesn't form any synapse. It comes directly from the spinal cord to the target organ. Remaining all sympathetic nerves follow these three pathways. You have to remember the collateral ganglion supplies postganglionic neural to the different target, and celiac collateral ganglia supplies postganglionic neurons to the esophagus, stomach, pancreas, liver, and the adrenal gland and the small intestine. A single branch is supplied to the large intestine also. So the superior mesenteric ganglion. So the superior mesenteric ganglion supplies postganglionic neuron to the, especially to the large intestine. So the third inferior mesenteric ganglion, collateral ganglion, supplies postganglionic neurons to the rectum part of the large intestine, kidneys, urinary bladder, and the reproductive organs. So this is about the collateral ganglion. So the function of the sympathetic neural system is mainly excitation. Preganglionic neurons secrete acetylcholine as a neurotransmitter, but the postganglionic neurons secrete noradrenaline as the neurotransmitter. As the neurons secrete noradrenaline as a neurotransmitter, these neurons are known as adrenergic neurons. As these sympathetic neural system secretes adrenaline as the neurotransmitter, so it prepares the body for the excitation. So it dilates the pupils, so the more light will be entered into the eye region so that the person can
see the environment clearly.
And salivary glands are also innervated by these nerves, nerve fibers, and inhibit the salivation. So they also innervate the trachea and the lungs. They dilate the tracheal region so that the more oxygen, more air will be entered into the lungs region. So more air enter into the lung region, more oxygen will be entered. So increases the heart rate. As the heartbeat is increased, more oxygen, more blood will be pumped out, and as more blood will be pumped out, more oxygen is supplied to the organs. So the digestion, in the stomach digestion will be inhibited. It stimulates the liver to
produce glucose.
So glucose release will be increased, and also pancreas. So insulin production will be lowered. So adrenal gland will be excited to liberate the fight or flight hormones, nephrine or epinephrine. Bladder will be relaxed. So all these are the different function of the sympathetic neural system. Sympathetic neural system. So let us learn about
parasympathetic neural system.
Here the nerve fibers of this system, that is parasympathetic neural system, arises from the cranium, that is arises from the brain and the part of the spinal cord. So the nerves, the cranial nerves, which are part of parasympathetic nervous system, are third cranial nerve, seventh cranial nerve, ninth cranial nerve, and the tenth cranial nerve. So, as the parasympathetic neural system consists of preganglionic fibers coming from the cranial nerves and the few spinal nerves, that's why this is known as a craniosacral outflow, as the information comes from the cranium and the sacral region of the spinal cord. This is known as a craniosacral outflow. So these are the cranial nerves. From these cranial nerves, preganglionic fibers of the parasympathetic nervous system comes out. So these are the preganglionic fibers. So they form synapse in the ganglion. So third, seventh, ninth, and ninth cranial nerves. So third, this is the seventh, and this is the ninth cranial nerve, and these form four ganglion. So pterygopalatine ganglion, ciliary ganglion, submandibular ganglion, and otic ganglion. So these four ganglion, from these ganglion, post ganglionic neurons supply to the lacrimal gland, eye, and the salivary glands. So next, the 10th cranial nerve, that is the vagus nerve. So the preganglionic fibers of the parasympathetic nervous system arise from the vagus nerve, and they goes to the terminal ganglia, which are present inside the visceral organs and thoracic organs. So these fibers, these are the plexus, that is the branches of the preganglionic fibers, and they innervate the thoracic and the abdominal organs, lungs, heart, and the digestive organs. So this is the, that is 10th cranial nerve is the last cranial outflow. Okay, so next, second, third, and fourth spinal nerves involved in the sacral outflow. These are the second, third, and the fourth spinal nerves, and these nerves form a pelvic plexus. So this is the network of branches of axons is known as a plexus. So from this plexus, nerves arises and they terminate in the terminal ganglion. From the terminal ganglion, postganglionic neurons are innervates the organs, especially the kidney, urinary bladder, and the reproductive organs. So the main function of this parasympathetic neural system is inhibitory function. As the sympathetic neural system excites the neurons, this system act antagonistic to the sympathetic neural system and calm down the body and brings the all organs to their resting or relaxing position. So both the sympathetic and parasympathetic neural system act antagonist. The functions are opposite. Okay, so here the preganglionic fibers are longer than the postganglionic fiber. So this is the preganglionic fiber and this is the postganglionic fiber. So here preganglionic fibers are longer than the postganglionic fibers. You have to remember this one. Here the ganglion are isolated and they are not united, as the sympathetic neural system, they unite and form a chain like structure. But in parasympathetic neural system, the ganglion are isolated, they are very close to the organs, or they are present inside the organs like the heart, lungs. In these organs, the terminal ganglia are present inside the organs. Here the ganglia are present very close to the organs. So the postganglionic nerve fiber is shorter in this neural system. So the neurotransmitter which is secreted by the postganglionic neuron is acetylcholine. That's why this system is known as a cholinergic system. Okay, the main difference between sympathetic and parasympathetic is the secretion of the neurotransmitter. In sympathetic neural system it is adrenaline. In parasympathetic neural system it is acetylcholine. So here the function is an inhibitory, so it calm down the body and it brings the organs to the relaxing or resting stage. So this parasympathetic neural system is not energy consuming system, okay. So this is about the parasympathetic neural system. Hope you understand.